The only way to cushion the third wave is to vaccinate, vaccinate and vaccinate as many people as we can. But India's pace has been woefully slow. The reason is shortage, and there is criticism about India not being prompt in looking at procuring vaccines like Pfizer and Moderna.
We should have anticipated the same happening here a little later. We should have capitalized on the large manufacturing capacity of vaccines that India has and finalized the deals with these companies to manufacture their vaccines in India. All this should have happened 4 or 5 months ago so that we could be using those vaccines now and seeing the pandemic through by September, October 21.
We underestimated the vaccine requirement, say public health experts.
It seems to have originated from insufficient amount of time and thinking given to supply and procurement of vaccines, and more attention was given on the prioritization of target population. We also need to remember that vaccine manufacturing is a complex process, and reliance on one or two vaccine manufacturers is something like putting all the eggs in single basket.
At least in its dealings with Pfizer, the deal breaker last year was the insistence on indemnity clause, and also Pfizer's insistence on not conducting bridging studies, conditions that India's drug regulator did not agree to. You know, Dr. Guleria, as early as the month of August and September last year, we were having a conversation about Pfizer approaching the regulators. Do you think the decision that the regulators have now taken, you know, apply for emergency use authorization, a decision is going to be taken in 3 days, carry on with bridging studies, this could have been done earlier, we could have saved more lives?
One could always argue that retrospectively, if we had done away with the bridging studies in the past and said that you can just approve vaccines with the regulatory approval being there from, let's say, the foreign regulators, we should accept that and go ahead. But then there was a lot of concern that in our own population, we may have side effects which may cause problems which may not have, which may not get picked up. And if that approval was given, then people would start criticizing the regulator for giving approval which were not really justified.
Now, a conversation is underway with both of these companies. The center also justifying the centralized policy of dealing with the companies themselves.
चाहे फाइजर हो मॉडर्ना हो हम उन सबके साथ सेंटर लेवल से कोऑर्डिनेट करते हुए उनको दो तरीके से फैसिलिटेट कर रहे हैं एक तो उनके रेगुलेटरी फैसिलिटेशन इन टर्म्स ऑफ अप्रूवल्स दूसरा प्रोक्योरमेंट रिलेटेड फैसिलिटेशन और बोथ फाइजर एंड मॉडर्ना मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम देयर ऑर्डर बुक्स इज ऑलरेडी फुल तो इट इज डिपेंडिंग ऑन देयर सरप्लस हाउ मच दे कैन प्रोवाइड टू इंडिया दे विल कम बैक टू गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया एंड विल एंश्योर एंड फैसिलिटेट कि उसके बेसिस पर हम वो सारी चीजें स्टेट लेवल पर उसको सप्लाई किया जा सके कोऑर्डिनेट किया जा सके फैसिलिटेट कर पाए
Moderna is expected to launch a single dose COVID-19 vaccine in India next year and is in talks with Cipla among other firms. While Moderna has conveyed to Indian authorities that it does not have surplus vaccines to share in 2021, US giant Pfizer is ready to offer 5 crore shots in 2021. But it continues to insist on regulatory relaxations, including indemnification, it enjoys in many other countries. Pfizer says it can provide vaccines in tranches of 1 crore. 1 crore in July, 1 crore in August and 2 crores in September, again a crore in October for supply to India this year, and that it's only going to be dealing with the government of India and payment for the vaccines will have to be made by the government of India to Pfizer India. In a statement to India Today, Pfizer said that it is committed to continue engagement with the government of India to support its fight against the pandemic and to make the Pfizer BioNTech COVID-19 vaccine available for use in the country. It also says the discussions are ongoing. At least 2 high-level meetings were held only last week to discuss the manner in which the widening gap between supply and demand of vaccine doses in India can be stemmed and how Pfizer and Moderna can be brought to the country. Pfizer has suggested that at least 116 countries have signed the indemnification document, and it expects India to do the same. Given the fact that over 14 crore doses of Pfizer's vaccine have been administered outside of India and very little serious adverse events, very few adverse events have been reported, and also that this vaccine is being given to children, makes the proposition of having this vaccine in India an exciting one. In New Delhi, Sneha Murdani for India Today.